Section 25th and 4 at 400.
Thank you. Thank you. anyway, ladies and gentlemen of America, fights high and says, let's create elections. And you gave us moments that we'll never forget. It was Blatney dropping to his knees in thanks. Mary Lou Retton getting that perfect 10. There was Steinsieber and Hogshead hitting the wall at the exact same 100th of it when something like USA, USA. But it doesn't matter whether you won the gold or the silver or the bronze, the cheer was for you, for all of you. The specialness of this Olympic was apparent from the beginning. A vibrant and a very human delight that was transmitted to them by what they saw of you. Then they think, Americans? Well, they're generous, full of serious effort. They're full of high spirits. They're motivated by all. It's got everyone in this city had to put him or herself out some way one way or another while the games were on. The South Korean boxers, the Chinese gymnasts, the Romanian athletes, the Jamaicans, the Japanese. For a lot of us, one of the really indelible images of the games was of Gabriella Anderson Scheiss of Switzerland, walking dazed and dehydrated to the finish line, refusing to give up, pushing on even when all her strength was gone, summoning up just that last bit of reserve and crossing that line. She truly was heroic. Read forever books about the melting pot, but the past 2 weeks, there it was, winning medals for us, representing us every day. 140 countries represented here, in the only place in the world where those who are competing for this nation had the bloodlines and the background of more than those 140 countries. And so I say to you, because you soared to greatness.